Good morning and welcome back to the channel. So today I'm actually going to do a bonus video. I'm not sure where I'm going to input this. Today is Sunday, so I'm probably gonna just like pop it up today, maybe tomorrow, or I don't know. But anyway, point is it's gonna be an Etsy share and kind of a show and tell to kind of give you guys up to date on what I've been doing when the camera's not on. So the first thing is going to be an Etsy share, and this is from CharsCraftyShop right here. I'm going to link her channel. There we go. I moved my camera because it fell down, go boom. So I moved it, so it's different now, and I have to get used to it all being realigned over here. Anyway, this is her shop right here, and I will link this in the description box for you. And this is what I bought. This is a goodie bag, and these are what I bought. I love these little things. They're super easy to just add to little cards or just all kinds of small things to give you an extra boosted little embellishment. And they're amazing. Like, these guys are hearts, okay, and they're flat. That's what I like. They're paper, so they're flat. And I love that. So I have no problem putting these in, I had to scooch over, putting these in junk journals and whatnot. And so these are the hearts. And actually, I think I got both packs I got of hearts because I have gotten her circle punches before. And those are also very, very cool. And I absolutely love this shop. Again, it is Char's Crafty Shop right there. I will link it. Also, I have had several people ask me, where's the link to this? Where's the link to that? It is in the description box. People have asked me for my email. People have asked me for, my shop. It's all in the description box for you guys. And if you have any questions as to where it's at, just ask. And again, like I'm doing now, I'll just tell you where it's at, or I'll post a link to it. Normally I just post a link to it. I'm like, it's in the description box, but here you go. So I thought this was super cute. I think this will make a really nice, Valentine's Day. Actually a lot of these will make really good Valentine's Day embellishments. So I know that it's really early to be thinking about that, but as a seller, I have to think about things like that, and I have to get them in my shop before Valentine's Day, you know? How Walmart and Target put Christmas stuff up in July. Yeah, kind of like that. Only not quite that obsessive. But, yeah. So, I thought those were super duper cute. By the way, I'm pretty sure I pulled something in my back or pinched something because it has been, like, all tweaky. And I don't know what it is. Actually, I think what it is I'm sitting in my chair more often because I don't smoke anymore. I quit smoking. Did I tell you guys that? I think I did. So I'm in my office a lot more often. Imagine that. You quit smoking so you have more time to do stuff. Isn't that crazy? So these are the freebies that she sent me, and aren't they cute? And I love how she puts like these little sequins in there. Like, I don't have the patience for that. But I did get something recently that hopefully will allow me to have a little bit more patience with them, because I have a ton of sequins because I used to do shaker cards, which I might do again. I don't know. I love this one, you know, the butterfly. Gotta love butterflies. For those of you who don't know, I have a butterfly on my arm. And a moth on this one. And paint. I've been painting. Just ignore the paint. So I have a Luna moth on this side and a butterfly on this side. Oi. So that is handmade embellishments from Char's Crafty Shop. So thank you, Miss Char. I very much appreciate these. Okay, and so the next one is, I feel a little weird because I normally don't do my own Etsy shop, but I did want to post these because I got them up and ready for the intention of giving, having them available for you guys before Christmas. So these are just little bitty notebooks. They're on my shop right now. They are way less expensive than my normal journals. They are also less intensive as my normal journals. So you have a front and a back cover, and they're all Christmas related. So this is a Christmas collage, and each one has three journaling cards in it. But my purpose of this was to have something that was very quick and small and compact that you could just throw in your purse and you could go. Or you could set it beside your nightstand if you thought of something in the middle of the night, because I don't know about y'all, but my brain is always going when it's time to sleep. So that's fun. And I figured it would be really nice to have something super quick, super easy, just to dot things down, like Christmas lists and shopping lists and stuff like that. So there's three journaling cards. Each book is going to be different. This particular book that I'm showing you guys right now is number 8, if you are interested in this particular one. They all are different, and they have coffee dyed paper in them, so that's all going to be different. As you guys know, there is no, even if you do the exact same batch, there's just, you're not going to get the same things. So these are on my shop right now. I literally just posted them to be available. There are 12 of them currently at this moment of recording, because I literally just put them on. But this is number 8. And this thing is not available on my shop. I have yet to decide if I'm going to put this on my shop. I just love it so much. I cannot bring myself to get rid of it. So I decided to start making a book last week, and well, I finished it. Well, there's a couple things that I can add, like to pages and such like that. But this is my fantasy journal. I have had people over the years tell me several times, do a fantasy journal, do a fantasy journal. Well, I made one. It's not completely all decked out. Like, it's not one of those alligator mouth journals. It is an actual book to where you can use it in writing. Like, you can write in this book. My purpose for this was to use it for writing. Like, that is why I created this. Because I love writing. And yes, I know that that page was upside down. It will make sense momentarily. So, this is the cover. It is textured. You can see the texture on there. There it is. You can see the texture. There's the spine. Nice and pretty. And there's the back. Nice and pretty. And I have not stamped this. If I sell it, which is a very big if, it will have a stamp on the back, handmade by Moi. So it will have that stamp somewhere, either on the back cover or on the back inside, but it will be permanently attached to the book. Obviously, if you are lucky enough to obtain this book, you can cover that up if you so choose. So it's silk ribbon. It is not seam binding. I did not want seam binding on here because seam binding will fray a lot more than silk ribbon does. And it's not as strong. So this is the inside cover. This is rice paper, actually. And this is the backside. And this came from the same sheet. As you can see, they match. Matchy match. There are 6 total signatures in here. Each signature has at least 10 sheets of paper. Therefore, each signature has 40 sheets. 40 times 6 is 240, I think. Yeah. Yeah, because 6 times 4 is 24, plus 0 is 240. I did math. Yay! Anyway, so this book has over 200 pages in it. And let's just do like a super quick flip through. There's a lot that's here that's not decorated at all. But again, I just wasn't sure if I wanted to keep it because I really, really, really love this journal. So this is an owl. This is some of my lace. There's a lot of my lace throughout this book. This is actually some coffee dyed paper that I did on camera back in the day when I used to do lives. I did that on camera. This is some old notebook paper. It actually came from a ledger, but I don't know that I have the cover for the ledger anymore. I might. I think it's in my bookshelf that's in my closet. This is some more of my lace. This is actually one of my favorite laces. This is very, very old notebook paper. Like, so old it's very fragile. Crazy. Just some sketching paper here. This is the manila envelope that I painted on camera when I was just like, let's get messy. Yeah, that's this. And I'm not sure if I keep it, I'm just not going to cover these until I get to those pages. Then I'll cover them. Possibly. I have no idea. I don't know what I'm doing. All I know is I love this book. Some more ledger paper. This one is fold out. I love the, oh my gosh, this is an envelope, and I cut the middle so you could use both sides of the envelope. Cause you know how, like, if you put the envelope in, you're sealing the envelope down basically. So I cut it. I put a little thing. I tapered the edge and made it to where I could use it. This is stationery paper, actually, but it's super soft. I love this paper. Some more ledger paper. And this one's folded up. My watch is making noise. My watch keeps telling me to breathe as if I'm not breathing. All right, so this one is a pocket, actually. It's got some lace folded over the side. This, I know, is upside down. This is a calendar page. I got all of these calendar pages from the wonderful Eve over in Switzerland, and they are just so gorgeous. I had to put them in here. So, dun dun dun. That's the first one. And I absolutely love this page. And these are all the middle of the signature. So again, there's the calendar page, and we're just going to do kind of a quicker flip through of these because you kind of get the general idea of what's in here. This is apparently sealed down. Oh, there we go. No, it's not. Okay. Ledger, fold out, other side of envelope, other side of sketch paper, lace, ledger, coffee dyed, bleep, ledger. And this is the second signature right here. So again, with the envelope, and again with the tapered edge. And this is a flower with lace, because I love my lace. This is actually a tarot card, but I put that there kind of to remind me that I have them, I think, and to kind of put them, scatter them throughout. This is another ledger page. This is the sketch paper that I told you about in the previous signature. But this is a belly band that I created with multiple layers of the laces that I've used throughout this book. And then this is a heart that I got from Padded Heart and Company off of Etsy. And more ledger. This one's a pocket, but I didn't sew this side, so it's just kind of a tuck. This is more ledger. This is a different ledger. Ledger. Fold out. Each signature has one of these. Each signature has this ledger paper. Each signature also has, go back, this envelope, which is usable. Yep. Yep. Ledger, fold out, bloop. And then the middle of the signature. Isn't she pretty? Oh, I just love it. Each one of the middle of the signature is sewn around. Sometimes it's just a simple sew around, and sometimes it's a little bit more. This one is just a simple sew around. This one's a simple sew around. The other ones, some of them are not. All right, so coffee, ledger, envelope, stationery ledger. This is a pocket, but it's on the other side. Sketching paper. This is thicker ledger. This, the very fragile notebook paper. The other pocket. This one is the third signature, and I love this page. And it just, I think it matches so well with everything else. And it's a pocket. I went ahead and sewed the edges down. This was the coffee dyed paper, and I just sewed the edges down instead of leaving it as a flap. So this is some ledger paper that I sewed around, and this one is a pocket. All of them have this page in it right here. Another ledger with some lace, some stationery. This is the sketch paper again. And this is not a pocket or anything. It's just kind of, it can flap up if you want, but it's got the same lace from earlier, and well, on this and this actually, and a cluster of flowers. More ledger, more envelope, more ledger, and doily. Boom. This is a coffee dyed doily that I dyed way back in the day before I was like, I'm not dyeing anymore. I'm just going to buy them from other people. I still have some of the stuff that I dyed a long time ago. And then this one here, I sewed around, but I also put lace across the corners because I thought that was really, really cute. And so I just sewed, it's not glued down or anything. It's just sewn across the edges. That's it. And I thought she was super pretty. I love the moth and the flame. I love it. Your calendar piece obviously is upside down because, well, I wanted the image. I'd rather the calendar be upside than the image be upside down. Upside? Upside down. Okay. So, ledger, envelope, ledger. Okay. And, oh, there we go. Stationery right here. What time are we at? Okay. Sketch. No, I'm sorry. This is another ledger, pocket. This one's another pocket here. And this is the fourth signature. Oh my gosh, there's six of these. Okay, so this is the fourth signature. It's got some lace in there, some ledger, oh, card. So those envelopes that I put in here, they had cards that go with them. So there's one of the cards. There's the other side of that. There is a flower cluster along with an image of a fairy riding a unicorn. And some more vintage paper, and some more stationery, another pocket, okay, poop. And this one, oh my word, oh, this is my favorite. Okay, so for one, I love the calendar page. It's amazing. But for two, bam, it's a dragon. Dun, dun, dun. I love him. Oh my goodness gracious, I love this page. And calendar page, another pocket, stationery page, envelope, ledger, the back of the card. See, like if I sell this, there's still a lot more work to be done because I will cover all of these backs of the cards. And I'll also cover the envelopes that are orange still in the middle. So this is another coffee dyed, and it's got some lace on the side. I used a lot of the purples and blues and greens and blacks kind of throughout to match with all of the center pieces and of course with, well, the cover. So it's another flower cluster here, some lacy lace, and then this folds out like that. Ledger, coffee, card. I actually sewed around the edges on this one here. Beautiful, beautiful card. The other side, another flower cluster here. Another orange envelope that will be covered if I decide to sell this. This is the only signature that has this. It's a folded bag. So you've got the pocket on the inside and then a top spot here. I tried to put something special in each of the different signatures. Like there's two of the signatures that have doilies. One of the signatures has this bag. Let's see, what does this one have that the others don't? Oh, some of the signatures have the envelopes. Not all of the signatures have the envelopes, but only two do. And then two have the card. So I tried to add something special to each one in addition to the pages that I've added to each one. So there's a tuck. And like this one here has this little extra page here as well as the card. So this one actually has two extra pages. And then this one is, I love this image as well. This is the Lady of Shalott. I think that's how you say it. I have no idea. But I love this image. And then this is the other side of that piece that I was showing you here. Paper, of course it's paper, stationery, ledger, pocket tuck, ledger, orange envelope. This is the other side of that card right there. And that's also sewn around, coffee dyed here. Nope. And working to get to the last signature now. And that's this one here. So another flower cluster here, lace on this side. Coffee dyed. And I'm sorry if I feel like I'm rushed through here, but a lot of this is very, like, to me, it's very plain. It's really all about the extra things that I have done to it, like all the laces and the center pieces, the stitchings, you know. There's a lot of pages like this that just have stitching around the edge. And then this one has the doily, which, oh my goodness, I love this one. I put a flower cluster on this. And this one is such a cute and middle piece as well. This is the calendar piece. And then here is the flower. No, she's not a flower fairy. I mean, she's a fairy that's covered in flowers. But the flower fairy is a very specific Celeste, I think. I don't remember the artist, but anyway, I don't think she's the same artist that has done this. There's the other half of the doily, ledger, the other stationery. This one's got some lace on this side, and I tried to kind of make it even so which ones were on this side, which ones were on that side. Here's some lace that I added. I actually had to add something here because when I sewed this lace on, this side was nice and pretty, and this side was my sewing machine. Like, I don't know what it did, but it messed up the stitches something fierce. And I was not about to rip all of that up because then I would have damaged the paper, and I only had so many of these left. So I covered it with lace. Why not? Coffee dyed, and then the last page is the last ledger. So like I said, this book has over 200 pages in it. This is a book. Yes, it is a journal, but this is not your traditional one signature journal. This is a very hefty journal, and I don't know if I'm going to sell it or not. If I sell it, I will have another video that's completely separate from everything that is only this book flip through, because if I sell it, then I need to have a video that only shows that product for the listing. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I didn't expect it to be over 20 minutes, so it might actually just go up Thursday, which is fine by me, and I hope is okay by you guys. Actually, I don't know. I don't know when I want to post this. I need to post it soon, though, so I can actually use these pieces from Char's Crafty Shop. So I'll probably just edit this and post it straight up today, which is Sunday. Anyway, you guys have a wonderful day. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed everything that I've shown you. And don't forget, go visit Miss Char over at Char's Crafty Shop. She has beautiful, beautiful, beautiful handmade embellishments. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye, guys.